Back in February, Adidas tweeted this pic, the bare breasts of 25 women. It was part of an ad campaign for their new sports bra collection.
One of the things that we wanted to do was make sure that we were really capturing the mindset of the consumer.
The other things they were hoping to capture?
We believe women's breasts in all shapes and sizes deserve support and comfort, which is why our new sports bra range contains 43 styles so everyone can find the right fit for them.
But the pics have now been banned by the UK's advertising watchdog, which ruled these boobs were likely to be seen as explicit nudity and shouldn't appear where kids can view them. The decision comes after a mind-blowing 24 people complained, arguing the ad objectified women and reduced them to body parts. Adidas also ran the ad on select billboards, which showed the bare breasts of 64 women. That's 78 more boobs. And they ran it on Instagram, but abided by Insta's rules and blurred the nips. Thank goodness.
Advertising isn't reflecting the same pace that society and social media is at in understanding gender and sexuality. So often we're seeing that advertising is probably about 10 years behind.
Adidas are standing proudly by their campaign. They say the ads show just how diverse breasts are and therefore how important the correct sports bra is.
It's our largest variety of band and bust sizes ever.
Often a lot of things that we're seeing is that women's bodies are judged in advertising for being sexual as opposed to being a physical body. And you aren't seeing those same laws being applied to the male form.
Australia's ad standards peeps don't have a problem with the pic on Instagram and have dismissed the complaints. They've yet to receive a complaint about the unblurred boobs on Twitter. So, are Adidas helping break down the boob barrier? Or, hang on, are they just hoping a bit of controversy helps sell 43 styles in 72 sizes of sports bra?
It does start a worldwide cultural conversation. This ad was banned in the UK, but we're talking about it in Australia, and it's something that needs to change.
Well, boys.
Do you want to go first, Peter?
Go on, Pete. What are your thoughts about boobs?
I'm going to let the ladies go first. And I'm interested to hear your thoughts. When I saw it, I was surprised there's been this much outrage and difference of opinion even within our office.
We had such an interesting conversation about it because, I mean, Lisa and I were they're trying to sell bras.
Totally. We're talking about it and that's exactly what this ad agency wanted. That is their job.
Correct. So given that's a big tick.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't need to show women breasts for women to know that we've all got different shaped breasts.
We already
know that. That's ludicrous. We know that. We've shared the horror of a communal change room. We know. And in the spirit of the communal change room, I'm like, I don't find that necessary. I don't think there's anything wrong with it, but I just don't find it necessary.
Well, the only boobs we care about are our own and whether or not we can get a bra that's going to be the best.
Yeah, but maybe the ad's not aimed at us then, Lise.
But I buy sports bras.
What?
Bought a sports bra recently, Helia.
I'm wearing it now, actually. I've got to say, it's pretty comfortable. But so you consider that nudity? Absolutely.
Well, it is nudity.
Yeah.
What do you consider nudity?
I was surprised to hear a lot of women in the office here at the project believe that this was not nudity. It's obviously they're not wearing clothes, so
yes.
Obviously they're not offended by it, though.
What's the definition of nudity if that's not nudity?
Well, it is. I agree. It's nudity. I'm just trying to.
But is it inappropriate nudity? Is the question,
but
I think.
Isn't the Freedom Nipple campaign? Is that a separate thing? Or?
But the thing that I found offensive was the use of the word offensive. It's women's boobs. I mean,
yes.
Boobs are a beautiful thing. You know,
yes,
women,
but I
appreciate
also think,
women's boobs.
I always think in these conversations, and particularly when women's bodies are always commodified,
mm-hmm.
because women's bodies are beautiful and magical.
Mm-hmm.
And my boobs are beautiful and magical. I don't find them offensive, but I do understand that people would be offended if I took my top off right now.
Yeah, I think when
we find out who they are. But
I think when they say the ad's offensive, I don't think they mean boobs are offensive inherently. I think they're talking about the presentation of that ad on an environment like there's no time watershed like you get on television or anything like that. It's sort of unrestricted. I think that's what they mean. They mean it offends a certain type.
But they don't want children to see them.
Yeah, that's what they're saying.
Which is fair enough because...
people can decide what they want their children to see.
Children have seen them up close. I mean, they you know.
But if you, you know what's interesting?
Which is a great thing. Bitty. But it's very complex and it's nuanced.
Yes. Mm.
But I also...
It's been fascinating to kind of observe and listen to the debates, various debates going on.
Yes, very interesting.